The Tularosa Basin Downwinders are individuals from central and southern New Mexico. They state that they have experienced undue hardship in the years since the Trinity Test because of the test's radioactive fallout. Many of the rural communities near the test site relied on cisterns and holding ponds for fresh water, and so radioactive fallout would have contaminated local water sources and food sources such as vegetables and animals. Eating food sources that have higher radiation levels can lead to various cancers, birth defects, and stillbirths. Downwinders believe the Trinity test led to increased rates of cancer among local residents, other diseases that have caused financial and social stress, and death. They are seeking recognition for their suffering and compensation under the Federal Radiation Exposure Compensation Act. When the Trinity site is open to the public twice a year, Downwinders and their supporters gather to protest. Jim Eckles shares his thoughts on this issue.
Fallout, which was generated in the explosion, this uptake of metal and sand and earth into the fireball and gets irradiated, and you've got all these elements made, these radioactive elements beyond the plutonium, cesium, radioactive iodine, et cetera, et cetera. Most of them fall back to steady states pretty quickly, but a lot of them have long half-lives, and so they live on as the fireball rises. Of course, it forms a mushroom cloud and goes up to 40,000 feet. And then the prevailing winds start carrying that cloud to the northeast. And of course, your bigger dust particles, materials are falling out at ground zero and immediately to the north. And the smaller stuff starts falling out beyond that. And so you've got a plume of material distributed to the northeast. You go straight down the middle of that plume, you've got fallout materials, and as you get out perpendicular to that, it gets less and less and less. And this 40,000 feet gets this radioactive fallout up into the upper winds. And so it ends up going completely around the planet. Kodak reports that some of their packing material around film has got some radioactive dust in it, apparently, and fogged some of their film. It's the straw that they used, which I think came from the Midwest. And of course, the fallout, once it hits the sandy soil, gets buried in the ground pretty quickly. It was probably a hazard for those first few weeks. It would have been close to the ground, on buildings, on foliage, things like that. The government didn't do much follow-up on that. Of course, standards were not the standards we have today either. They tolerated much more radiological exposure than we would today. So there is a group right now, for instance, the Tularosa Downwinders, claiming that ranchers in their area were exposed. The only problem they have is that in that map that Los Alamos produced where they measured radiation, Tularosa in the immediate area is not in that plume at all. The fallout's still there, buried in soil somewhere. Whether you can find it and prove that it came from Trinity site, something I don't know anything about. It's still a sensitive issue. And at the open houses, we have protesters that sit outside the gate and carry signs, letting the public know that this is still a concern for some people.